G'day, I'm Clive and welcome to CDP Outdoor. Today's video is the second section of the Bibbulmun Track, the Hewetts Hill shelter to the Boar Creek shelter, take two. Just leaving the Hewett shelter. And the reason I'm making this video again is the first time I made it, I used my mobile phone and it was about 2 years ago. And it was a bit shaky. So the video quality and the audio quality wasn't that good. So this is take two. When I got to the Hewett shelter this morning, there were some young ones. Really nice and polite. And really respectful, keeping the place nice and clean. It's really good to see. This part of the Bibbulmun Track from Hewetts to Boar Creek is shared by a couple of other tracks, and there is a four-wheel drive track and you're getting cyclists on this side also. A lot of the Bibbulmun Track cyclists or any form of wheels aren't allowed. Just be aware on this side that you will meet up with the odd cyclist, which they are allowed on certain parts here. Other parts on this section are not, so just keep your eyes open. Out of breath a bit from just walking up a incline. Over this mist here. No, you can't see the other side of the valley or anything, but it's just beautiful. Some Mother Nature's art. I don't know if you can see in the background there, the mist is just starting to lift or disappear. So far it's been a beautiful morning's walk. Even though it's only just gone 9 o'clock, the amount of people I've seen out here. Like I said, when I got to the shelter this morning to start today's walk, there's a group of young people there, four of them. And then there was two women turned up and then carried on walking. And I've just had a group of about 12, 14 young ones walking the opposite way. So it's quite busy out here today. I wasn't expecting it to be so busy with it being a Thursday morning. But it is. If you're worrying about doing a Bibbulmun Track and being on your own and not seeing people, it is very few times I've been on the Bibbulmun Track that I haven't seen somebody at one point or another. I've spent probably about 75% of my nights out, lucky enough, without anybody else in the camp or the shelter, which is rather nice. No snoring. but it's nice meeting people along the way. And some of these people have actually become friends. Yeah, no need to be afraid of coming out here. You meet new mates. Here we are, the southern lookout. Looking down over the Mundaring Weir. Isn't it just beautiful? Let's carry on walking. The southern lookout, and it's also known as the Golden View. There's a car park, only about 50, 75 metres away. So if you're thinking of only doing part of this section, you can be picked up from there. Or if you want to be a little bit clever, just carry a day pack and have somebody drop off a bit more there, or a bigger pack, or you can even wait until you get to the Mundaring Weir Hotel, or even the Discovery Centre. So there's multiple spots along this section you could be picked up or dropped off, or have supplies dropped off to you. And a lot of people worry because this first section from Kalamunda to Dwelling Up is the largest number of days, and get concerned about points where they have things dropped off, and the concern that they're not able to. But there is a large amount of points you can have supplies dropped off. Like I said, we've got the south from Kalamunda, we've got at least one road, and you've got the one where you've got the camel farm, and you've got Asher Road, and you've got the southern lookout here, and you've got the Mundaring Weir Road, and the actual lookout on the Mundaring Weir. You can cross the opposite side, and you've got the Mundaring Weir Hotel. And you've got the Discovery Centre, and then from the Discovery Centre to the next drop-off point or pick-up point is on Dale Road, which is this road out. We've got Helena, Worley, Barakin. So that's 3 days food you have to carry, and somebody can meet you at Dale Road, and you can get a resupply there. And then another day's walk, you're at the Brookton Highway. So you can even be resupplied there or picked up. And then the next one after that is Sullivan's Rock on Albany Highway. So that's only another 2-3 days after that. And then 2 days after that, you're down at the old North Bannister Roadhouse. You can have stuff dropped off there, or you can be dropped off or picked up or resupplies. And then the longest bit would then be from that point to Dwellingrock, which is 4 days. So the longest point for resupply is at 4 days. Or you can do like some do, they just carry the whole lot. But if you don't want to do that, you want to keep your pack light, you've got many options there to resupply or to be picked up if anything happens, or if you have a failure with your sleep mat, you can have somebody drop a new one off to you there at either point. So when you look at it that way, it's not the longest point between being able to stock up and resupply. So if you've got somebody who's willing to resupply for you, your pack can be a lot lighter. When I got to the south ledge, or the southern lookout, I swapped my hats. I took my merino wool beanie off because the sun was still very low and it was in my eyes, and I was having difficulty seeing where I was going. So I swapped it with my baseball cap with a peak on. I just wish I had a beanie with a peak on, because I can feel the cold on my ears and around the back of my head where the beanie was. I actually carry 3 hats most of the time. I have my baseball cap when it's warm. I have my normal beanie, which is when it's only cold or when I'm sleeping in my hammock. And then I have a fleece beanie or fleece cap, which is for when it's really cold. Carrying that little bit of extra weight, if people are worried about the weight with having 3 caps or 3 hats, I'm comfortable all day and night no matter what the weather is. So that extra couple of 100 grams makes no difference to me. I'd rather be comfortable. I made it to the Mundaren Weir. And unlucky, the gates are open. So let's take a walk across. Isn't this beautiful? Look at the view. All the way down there. And can't see it from here at the moment, so I'll carry on across and I'll show you where we were at the southern lookout on the golden view. Look at that water just sparkling in the sun. Isn't that just beautiful? And there's the old pump house down there. If the gates are closed, you can actually walk all the way down. Down, 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 down. There's a small bridge over here. You can cross the bridge and then you start walking all the way back across the car park and up those steps there and back up to the top. We're lucky today, we've got the gate open, so we can walk across the weir. So there's a small bridge you cross over to get to the steps on the other side to come back up if the gates are closed on the weir. And up there, about centre of the screen, is the southern lookout, the golden view. That's where I was looking down onto here when it was covered in mist, and I did the small time lapse. How bad that for a view? Not me. That. It's beautiful, isn't it? Alright, just come off the weir. You got steps there, you don't take them. You go up this track here. I've seen people make the mistake and go up the steps and try and figure out where they are. That's why I'm showing you this. There you go, now there's a pipe, and I'm going to end up the steps carved in there. The arse of the trees there is the Mandarin Weir Hotel. Nearly to that point. Like I said, this is one of the points you can use for a drop off, pick up, or even a food drop. You have to, excuse me, out of breath climbing them steps. You know what? I've been a right dummy. I took my jacket off down at the Mandarin Weir Hotel and I forgot to take the microphone out of the pocket and off the lapel. So all the video where I've been talking and describing things between there and here didn't pick my voice up. Some nice shots though. I've just gone through the Perth Hills Discovery Centre and they've got another campsite there, paid one. I think it's like $25 a night, I'm not certain. Normally you have to make a booking on the site it says, but I have turned up there and there has been spaces. So if you're lucky enough and you want to stop before you carry on to the Ball Creek shelter, so I just tried to go up a step and went backwards for the night and use their facilities there. They've got hot showers, they've got toilets, they've got a camp kitchen, barbecue, so if you want to, it is a nice little spot. It's also good for having some food dropped off, or if you're carrying something that you don't think you're going to use, you can have somebody come and pick it up off you from that point. And that's on at the top of Allen Road, up by Mandarin Weir, just past the Mandarin Weir Hotel. Like I say, I've been stopping and making videos and taking photos. So I think the second time I did this, I wasn't filming, or No, I've been averaging 4.6 kilometers an hour, so that would have meant 2.5 hours to do this section. But up to now, like, it's been 4 hours, which I don't mind. Like I said, I've been stopping, and hopefully I got some beautiful shots. I did spend about half an hour at the South Edge lookout, where I did a time lapse, which hopefully that worked out and you enjoyed that earlier on in the video. I was there for over half an hour. 500 meters to go. And I could feel my ribs and my back aching. I think I've had my pack set up slightly different to normal. That's okay, I've made it here. And I am carrying extra weight in it today. So I'll see you when I get down to the Boar Creek shelter. Summary of today's walk. This section from the Hewett shelter to the Boar Creek shelter is probably a medium grade, I'd say. Some little difficult bits, but altogether it's not too bad. It's not the easiest. You've got a bit of incline and decline and a few steps which are a bit of a pain because they're all uneven. So take your time going up and down them steps and you'll be fine. The walk today was, it was lovely. We had the mist this morning. It silhouetted the trees. It looks, I don't know if you call it mystical or spooky, somebody would say. But it was really, really nice. Cold. Hit about 9 o'clock and it began to warm up. So the jacket eventually came off, I think about 10 o'clock, 10:30, and yeah, it was just nice weather to walk in today. So if you're thinking of doing this section, it is a nice section. It's, you could easily do it in a day, walk here, and if you're okay in fitness, you could make it back. If not, you could walk all the way here and arrange for somebody to pick you up from the Discovery Center, which is 2.6 kilometers from this point. I hope you've enjoyed this retake of my video, because the first one was filmed on my phone and it was a bit shaky. And if you have, please go down below and click on the subscribe button, click on the like button, and click on the notification bell so you can be notified of all future videos. So until next time, get out there, have some fun, and take care. Thank you.